Hi guys, welcome to the Craft Beer Channel and Merry f***ing Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I've dressed up beautifully, Brad's decided to go hunting after this. So it's Christmas, we've gone on a whip round around Aldi, which begs the question, which one of us is Kerry Katona?
I'm Pierre André, mate.
So we've got four beautiful Belgian Christmas beers because I feel like Belgian brewers would do Christmas best.
When I think of a drink that you would drink at Christmas other than port and things like that, it's strong, hearty, warming, very strong Belgian beers.
And they just love anything kitsch, which you can tell from every beer label you've ever looked at.
Indeedy.
So beer number one we're going is Kitsch As It Comes, and that is Delirium Christmas. So this is, it's a pink elephant with a Christmas hat and scarf on.
Of course it is.
It screams Christmas to me.
Yeah.
Oh, it nearly spat at me.
We know those guys are pretty eccentric with their little delirium cult and all that kind of
exactly,
crazy stuff.
Exactly, yeah. Which I'm now a member of.
You need to get
graduate
on that.
From that. Oh, it's like alcoholic soaked raisins.
Yeah, it's making me make my mouth water.
That's really nice. It's really smooth and sweet and Christmassy.
Mm.
Not a huge amount of spices coming through, but it is kind of like a fruitcake.
Yeah.
Which is what I'd want.
All the fruit, not so much the spice.
Yeah, somewhere between fruitcake and banana cake.
Yeah. If we had to match it with one of our lovely little selections.
One of our oldie
delicacies. I feel more savoury because it is quite sweet.
It is quite sweet. You think we should go with the turkey and stuffing crisp?
Let's give it a go.
I'm not sure a turkey's been near that crisp.
Works for me.
I don't hate it, Brad.
Hmm.
That's as far as you can say with putting 10% beer with crisps. Number two wins, even though we haven't even tasted it, it wins the most kitsch beer. It's two gnomes dressed up for Christmas lighting a fire.
Yeah, it's an awful label.
Yeah. Smells a bit creamier.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit more rounded than the delirium, less sweet.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, totally less sweet.
More kind of datey, raisiny, what you'd expect from like a Belgian double, but amplified a bit.
Yeah, very smooth again.
I'd really like that, actually.
I like it.
I could drink that all day. Well, I could try.
You could try until we fell over.
What would we put it with? Maybe Terry's Chocolate Orange. I think it's dark enough.
Could be. I guess it's, but the sweetness of this might balance it out.
Yeah.
And that.
The only way to find out is to bang that endlessly against the table until it breaks apart.
That's it.
And then eat it in one go.
The great Christmas tradition.
The Christmas.
Of trying to smash.
A chocolate orange.
Right.
You know you haven't done that. Holy crap.
Look. I'm not lying. Look.
It's a Christmas miracle.
It is a Christmas miracle right there, guys.
Cointreau. That's what that tastes
somehow,
like together.
Yeah, it's got a look.
A boozy, spicy, orangey drink.
Mad liqueur vibes going on.
Okay with that. So Christmas beer number three is a brewery that we know well.
Oh, like we did there.
It's De Dolle Brouwers, with a 12% beer. So if I just slurred them, God knows what's going to happen after we've had this one.
I've gone straight in for a taste, Johnny.
Did you didn't don't need the aroma.
I did a little quick sniffy and then I went straight for it. Smells good. Tastes great.
Does it? I don't know yet.
Sorry. It's good, isn't it?
That's bloody lovely. You get a load of spices from that.
Mm.
I don't know what they brewed it with, but you get a kind of anise or something like that. Like a savoury licorice-ness. And you get the cloudy kind of apple thing. Then you get all the Belgian yeastiness, the nail polish and the banana and the clove and the...
It's really bloody Christmassy, isn't it?
Yeah. I think with the spicy warmth of that, it would be best with a gingerbread man.
I feel you.
Mm.
I feel like that's a great choice.
Should we try a bit of gingerbread man with
it? It's such a shame to break them though, Jay.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? I mean, you've done sterling work there.
I know, right?
That's art school on a biscuit.
4 years at Central St. Martins.
You spent 4 years.
To come up with that.
I'm sure you've done things since. Wow. Aldi knows how to make a gingerbread man.
Mmm, that's good.
They're great together. It's like they're one. It's like that Christmas single, Two Become One by Spice Girls. Yeah. Okay, well, so our final beer is 10% again. It's St. Bernardus, it's a Christmas ale. Dark and cloudy. It's like the night before a white Christmas, when you know the snow is coming.
How poetic.
I think that's the most bitter.
It's definitely more bitter.
Yeah, I get some hops, some hop bite at the back. For sure. And that kind of distracts you from the alcohol as well, which is always pleasant. Yeah, it's quite gingery as well. But I think it's darkness, it's darker fruits would go really well with a minced pie from Lidl.
Cheers. It's too big, Johnny.
What are you talking about? I'm getting a lot of pie, not a lot of mince.
It's a lot of pastry.
Yeah. Mouth so dry.
That's good.
That matches a dream. I can highly recommend the beer, but not the mince pie. I
think if you've got a beer that good.
Yeah, you don't need a good mince pie.
You don't need a good mince pie.
Yeah, you just need something to dry your mouth out so you can justify having another sip.
That's taken that from about 4 to 11.
Yeah.
That's banging.
So Brad, as it's Christmas morning,
yeah,
you've come down in your blue and white striped PJs.
Ooh.
Your snowman's melted, but I present you with a bottle-shaped present all wrapped up. Which of these beers would you want it to be?
I love the match, the sweetness of the ice with the orangey full-onness of that chocolate. I thought it was super luxuriant and indulgent.
Yeah,
and just Christmas for me.
Yeah, it did make like an orange liqueur kind of thing.
Yeah.
But for the second time this month, I've got to pick the Didola. Partly because, being really nerdy about it, I know that straight from the barrel, the barrel-aged version is just fantastic.
Oh, glorious. Yeah.
But no, I just love the complexity of that, while still being hugely, hugely drinkable. And 2% more than these guys. Yeah. There's red wine, less alcoholic than that, and it tastes like a dream. So we wish you a very, 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 very Merry Christmas, and it will be a very, very Merry Christmas if you have all four of these beers. So from me and the Brad, all the best over the festive season.
Cheers, buddy. Come here. Come here, big guy.